always hate to complain. But listen, everybody that's here, I just need you to interact. You got me? Please? Yeah. Please? Can I get a yes from everyone, please? Play.
You like that? Sing the motherfucking words, y'all.
Jumper, coolest podcast in the world. Today we're here with
XXXTENTACION.
See, I'm making you say your own name because I've been looking at it online for the past few months and I didn't really know how to say it. But hey man, it's nice to have you in the studio.
I appreciate it, brother. Thank you.
And I guess you should, well, we got No Jumper alumni Craig Zen over here on the left. Maybe you should introduce your homie.
Like, the ridiculous crowd that goes as far as I can see right now is a pretty good symbol of how much of an impact he made on so many people. And I just want to thank everybody for coming out. Obviously, I'm kind of losing my composure here, as I'm sure a lot of you guys are.
Safe, bro. Let's go. It's boiling, isn't it?
Yeah.
Here we are, mate. The freaking forest.
We've
got to check by doing this. F*** off! I've got a mosquito on me, mate. On the 18th of June 2018, one of the world's most controversial yet inspirational rappers, XXXTentacion, was
shot while leaving a motorsports dealership 40 miles outside Miami. His real name was Jase Onfroy. The Broward County Sheriff's Department later confirmed his death. Authorities say two men fled the scene in a dark SUV after one had opened fire, and what investigators say may have been a robbery.
He was only 20 years old. X is a rapper that touched multiple people's hearts in many different ways, and here at Unknown, we were certainly no exception. X was one of our favourite artists of all time, and we'd followed his journey basically from the start. A lot of rappers that sadly pass from being murdered or even dying from old age often receive documentaries, films, and TV shows made about them. Due to X's controversial past, we knew that this would not be the case with him. And despite the problems with his personality, in general, he was an inspirational figure who created some amazing music. And everyone deserves a decent send-off when they die at 20 years old. So this is for Jase himself and all of his fans across the world. This is the life and death of XXXTentacion.
Yeah. Well, I bought me a new gun. 2 times 1, 2 niggas 2. I need to shoot one, and I shoot my nigga today. Don't shoot me a nigga.
That's Billy Raps.
And I mean Billy one, too. Shoot a nigga who was walking over y'all.
Turn to get Bears. Third actor, Jase Onfroy, a.k.a.
the winner.
So of course, the obvious place to start is with the early life and upbringing of XXXTentacion. Born on the 23rd of January 1998 to Dwayne Ricardo Onfroy and Cleopatra Bernard, X was instantly exposed to the hood lifestyle, thanks to being raised mainly in Lauderhill, Broward County, which is one of America's most crime-ridden areas, with over 650 annual crimes, meaning only safer than 9% of the 3,000 US cities. With his father being locked up and basically never being around, his mother had a massive task at hand, as well as dealing with her own issues, so this is why X was predominantly raised by his grandmother. My mom was just in situations where she couldn't take care of me.
Like, niggas done drive-bys on me when I was like a jit type shit. Like, my mom just had me, like, she was in a situation where, like, she wanted me around, but she couldn't afford to, like, because of shit she was around, you know. She was still growing up. Like, my mom was raised in Jamaica.
But what was she around? Was she around a lot of, like, drug dealing and crime? Just, or, like, yeah. Why is she around motherfuckers that were beating her up and you got to stab them?
She just, to put it in a simpler term, like, my mom wasn't a prostitute or nothing, but, like, She just wasn't in a very stable environment because she had no help at that. Like,
right.
My mom just had it hard, bro.
And he understood why his mom couldn't always be there for him, and he certainly doesn't have any hard feelings towards her because of it.
I get what she was doing, so I don't resent her. I would never resent my mom, but like, my mom had it hard, I had it hard.
X said that his relationship with his mother was very strange, but he clearly idolized her unbelievable amounts. He said, and I quote, "My mom is like the spitting image of me, but
probably more, you know, pretty."
Although his mother often got herself into very dangerous situations, he said he knew she could always handle it. And again, another quote, "My mom is
the only girl that could beat me up."
Really?
Yeah, probably.
What about Ronda Rousey?
Ronda Rousey? No, I'll throw hands with Ronda Rousey.
Okay.
That's good to know. Ronda Rousey, you can see me with the hands.
In fact, it was actually his mother who encouraged him to get gold teeth from a very young age. And this shows how invested into the hood lifestyle his mother really was. This is all they knew.
Girls is everything, to be honest.
Yeah,
that's
bro.
What you need, it's like becoming a man. It's like getting, it's like losing your virginity once you're like 16 or so.
It's like becoming, it's like from boy to thug.
Yeah.
As a young lad with no father figure around, a very strange relationship with his mother, and being brought up in a very crime-ridden area, as you can imagine, X was no golden child.
Basically, a nigga tried to put his hands on my mom type shit.
And you were how young?
I was like six.
Stabbed him.
And
I bit
his flesh out and like grabbed the glass shard and like poked him with it type shit. Like stabbed him with it. Like,
wow.
And I was like,
at only 6 years old, he attempted to stab a man that he was saying was attacking his mother. After multiple acts like this, he was then put on a behavioral correctional program at Sheridan House, thanks to being kicked out of many middle schools for fighting.
How you get kicked out of middle school?
Oh. Yeah, kicked out of middle school. Why? That's a good question. You're right. You're filling in the blanks.
What did I get? All right. There's a list of shit.
You didn't.
I remember I beat some niggas like shouts out to him. I fuck with him now. We're cool now. Yeah, there was this fat kid in my class that made fun of my mom. I kicked him in his mouth.
Oh, fat kid.
X said he loved fighting and had been doing it since he was only a kid.
What, he's always been throwing the hands or what?
I mean, I've been there plenty situations, like plenty fights. Like, I knew him for 4 years. Yeah.
However, interestingly, X actually said that a lot of the fighting was because he wanted attention from his mother. He knew if he fought kids at school, his mom would actually give him attention because she'd have to tell him off. And any type of attention from her was good in his eyes.
As he grew up through his teenage years, the massive passion began to develop regarding music. This is something his mother and aunt recognised, and they actually signed him up for a chorus class, which he was later kicked out for, unsurprisingly, punching a classmate, who he stated kept punching him during a live performance. The music X grew up listening to was not all rap. He actually enjoyed hard rock and metal as a young boy. This genre of music does creep into many of his popular songs, thanks to the use of his aggressive and throaty vocals. After getting removed from the music class, X still had a massive passion for music. But instead of chasing the dream, his later teenage years were full of countless crimes, thanks to the crowd he surrounded himself with, and the feeling of having no hope or motivation, many people in these situations turn to dark paths. In 2013, X spent a year in a juvenile prison for charges of gun possession, armed robbery, and much more. In fact, he had one of the longest list of offences in a prison.
Armed robbery.
What was that like?
No, it's going to keep going.
Okay, yeah.
Armed robbery. Yeah, and this is not me being cool. This is not me saying this shit is okay.
We don't condone this shit.
I was just fucking up, you know?
Allegedly.
Armed robbery, armed burglary.
Possession
of a firearm. Armed burglary with dwelling. Resisting without violence. Grand theft of three charges.
Yeah, he got a lot of charges.
Possession of oxycodone.
They was trying to direct filed his ass.
Yeah.
I seen all these charges. Like, I seen it. Like, we went to court.
I had the worst charges in the jail.
The judge read the charges to him, and I'm looking at this nigga like, what the fuck is little nigga is?
I don't even know where to start on that list, though. Like, and where to start? Like, why are you stealing cars, number one? Why are you selling all
these
pills?
No, it wasn't even cars. It was the amount of houses I robbed. Like,
luckily for him, this instantly gained him respect from other inmates, meaning he really didn't have a hard time in prison. They do say everything happens for a reason, and maybe this case is true. In prison, X met Stokely Goulburn, aka Ski Master Slump God, who at this point also dreamt of being a rapper, but felt he had no hope. But as you know, these two have gone on for great success together. X meeting Ski in prison is one of the big factors in the making of his career, him as a person, and this is something we will pick up on later.
During Jess's time in prison, one of his greatest controversies came about, and this is something that haunted his career for the rest of his life. When the media had discovered that X had beat a gay man half to death in prison, people instantly assumed he was homophobic. Although these actions are something that can never be made okay, this is the defense that X made on the No Jumper podcast.
I am not homosexual. I am not homophobic. So if a homosexual man is around me, I will not act like a fucking prick. You know, I'm not gonna act like a piece of shit and be like, oh, he's a faggot, I don't want him.
But if he tries to rape you,
I'm gonna okay. bash his skull.
That to me is where you cross the line.
Exactly.
Yeah. Rape thing. Yeah. Okay.
Feel me? I've got gay friends. I know gay people. Gay people are cool. All right. So basically, they put him in the room. They put him in a room with Ski. And
I got the fuck out of there first quarter. Nigga was sitting in the corner staring at me. Right. So I'm like, shit. Bro. If you keep staring at me, I'm going to beat your ass, bro, and I'm going to get another charge for you. And I really not trying to catch another charge because we in here for some dumb shit. We going to sit like 6 months, go to a different program for some dumb shit. I'm not trying to do all. Anyway, so he's sitting in the corner staring at me. So I'm just banging on the door. I'm like, yeah, y'all got to get me the fuck up out of here, bro. And I just kept banging on that I kept banging on that shit till they let me out. So they put him in my
room. All right, I'm going to tell you that part. So, like, my level of respect for everybody within the jail was like, I wasn't a fucking prick. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Like, I wanted everybody to be kosher. I wanted everybody to be calm and, like, just move as a family type shit. You feel me?
Right.
So I respected the officers. A lot of niggas came in there trying to disrespect the officers. I was never that guy. So they came to me after they kicked him out his room and asked me if they could put him in my room. And I looked at them and I laughed. And I was like, y'all could put him in my room, but if he does anything I disapprove of, I'm going to kill him. And I'm not going to give you any warning. Like, and I said it just like that. And I put it on my life. I said it like that. And they was like, all right, that's fine. As long as he don't touch you, you shouldn't have to put your hands on him. And I was like, all right, that's fine. So they put him in my room. First few days, he was straight. Like, he was cool. He read his books. I stayed in my corner. He did his thing. You feel me? He asked me a few questions. That was fine. Like I said, I'm not homophobic. One day, he just got sus. Like, he was staring at me type shit. He was staring at me throughout the day. And, like, bro, jail makes you crazy.
Yeah.
Like, I was fucking crazy. Like, ask him. There was days where I'd slam my head on the fucking door for no reason. Like, I just wake up and
just
be like, fuck.
You want to feel something. What the fuck else are you going to do? Like,
and there's crazy people in there.
So I'm like, yo, I warned you. And I laugh. And I laugh because that's all I say.
Right.
I laughed and I said, I warned you. So I walked out the room to go take my shower and I came back in. And I was trying to calm down, kind of be kosher. So I turn around and I see this nigga staring at me while I'm putting on my jumpsuit. You got to
be in a towel
in front of the nigga. You have to get naked in front of your friends,
right,
type shit. So that's why it's better to be in a room with your niggas you fuck with. You feel me? Because
right,
if you get a weirdo, it's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So I go in the corner by the toilet type shit and put and tie on my jumpsuit. And I don't put it on all the way. I tie it around my waist and I start beating his face in and then when I did that, like, I tried to strangle him. Like, I was. And long story short, I was going to kill him type shit. Luckily, because I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be speaking to you. I wouldn't be as far as I was. You feel me? I wouldn't be successful. Luckily, a guard came over and I said, I told y'all I would kill him. I told y'all. And the thing was, like, they respected that. You feel me? Because, like, I told them what I was going to do. Like, it's not like.
You're saying the cops respect or the guards respected it.
The guards respected it. Because, like, They put me in a room with someone that made me uncomfortable, and I said that was perfectly fine. You feel me?
So, yeah. So you didn't actually get in trouble for doing this to him?
No, because no. I finessed it,
but I did get in trouble the first day. So what happened was, after I did that, like I said, the guards really, 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 I'm not going to say no names because I'm not a snitch, you feel me, but like, the guards really, really, really fucked with me.
Uh-huh.
So they told me, go to the bathroom, wash the blood off your hands. And bro, I swear, in my face. He said, I swear to God when I say this. He told me, take it off my hands, and my mom is in the visitation. Go see my mom. I went to visitation with blood on my fingernails. My mom saw the blood in my fingernails and asked me, what did you do? She looked at me and asked me, what did you do? Because I just had this smug, like empty look on my face. So what they did was they cut my visitation short. Literally, as soon as my mom says, don't you know that they can take you away?
They rush in and grab you?
Rushed. Cliche as fuck, but they rushed in, grabbed me, and they took me to what is the hole.
Yeah.
And the hole is where you're by your fucking self. You have no mat. It's just a concrete slab.
That shit feels smaller than all the regular cells. It like it makes you go crazy, literally. Yes. Right. You're just sitting there, feel like the walls get smaller, bro.
Nothing, bro. Nothing. Like
how long were you in there for? You don't even know?
It was the rest of the day, right?
Yeah, it was the rest of the day. That shit could make you go crazy, though.
I put him in the ER, so they had to keep me in there for like the rest of the day type shit, but...
So that is the defense from the man himself. You can make of this story whatever you wish.
As I previously mentioned, in prison, X met Ski Mask, and they soon became best friends. They were both aspiring rappers and used to freestyle together in jail.
And her mom, she won't fuck me some, fuck for some. Got my it turned off.
Just before X was sent to jail, he released his first rap song called Newsflop, which he claims was one of the best songs for telling a story. However, there's simply no record of this song and you can't find it online. X and Ski were released from prison at roughly the same time. They quickly met up together to plan a series of robberies and home invasions for monetary gain. However, X's girlfriend, Geneva Ayala, showed him the light that music was a better path to go down, and he should leave all the crime behind, and Ski followed suit.
And this is where the music journey begins.
I'm not even gonna lie. I need you to pronounce your name, please.
Yo, all right. XXXTentacion. All right, so XXXTentacion means unknown temptation. As far as the X, the significance of the X, for some time, the X was the only unknown numeral to me. So it was, it played as, like, it's like being John, like John Doe. You get what I'm saying? John Doe stands for unknown. So
okay, X is the variable, like the wild card.
As an unknown. So temptation is, tentacion is temptation in Latin. So I actually just pushed the two together in Unknown Temptation because I feel as if that's what my life revolves around.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Taking my dick in my pants.
So in March 2014, X released his first official single on SoundCloud. This was named Vice City and was presented in a very typical and traditional rap style of boom bap, which is nothing like his later releases from today. Later that year, X released two EPs named The Fool and Ice Hotel, which didn't break out of his fan base at all. And around the same time these were released, X joined Ski's collaborative group called Very Rare, and later they both left to create Members Only together. On April the 20th, 2015, Members Only released their first EP, called Members Only Volume 1. Despite the success from the two young rappers, X soon went back to his old ways and was charged with robberies, home invasion, and aggravated battery. At this point, he was not sentenced. Finally, on the last day of 2015, X began to break out from his fan base. His first major single, Look At Me, was released. And a month later, in the start of 2016, this became his first ever official download. Bitch, you was your mess, ayy. Can't keep my dick in my pants, ayy. My bitch don't love me no more, ayy. She kick me out on life, bro, ayy. That bitch don't wanna be friends, ayy. I give her dick, she I'm mad, ayy. She put her 10 on my dick, ayy. Look at my wrist, about 10, ayy. Just got a pound of the booth, ayy. But that shit straight to the... Around this time is when X claimed he changed massively, and as a fan, it was noticeable. X began to display powerful messages relating to his mental health problems, his deep inner thoughts, and began to grow a close relationship with his loyal fans.
How are you? I won't be long. I really just wanted to directly communicate with those that pay attention to what I'm doing and that support me. And I wanted to offer some words of inspiration and honestly ask a question. For the words of inspiration, I just really wanted to tell you guys that it does not matter what your dream is or what your goal is. You make sure that it is your prime priority to follow what you believe is good for you. Do not live your life trying to impress someone else, and do not live your life trying to be someone you're not, and do not live your life making yourself miserable just to amount to someone else's idealism. You don't want your life to be the structure of someone else's dream. You don't want to be following someone that's taking you down a dark road.
Ever since X was young, he claimed he struggled with mental health. He often felt depressed and insecure and actually attempted suicide multiple times. He began to really care about the way he presented himself and went from drugs and violence to trying to be a good person and teach younger kids to follow the right path.
Opportunity presents itself, you're gonna chase it. So my thing is, like, if you have too much fucking ice cream, you're not gonna want any more ice cream. If you have too much of me, you're not gonna want too much of me. If you have too much of Ski, you're not gonna want too much of this. So too much of anything is a horrible thing. None of nothing. Like, if you don't supply and there's a heavy demand, when you drop anything or you give out, it's gonna skyrocket. So anybody that wants to be smart, zero supply, well, one supply, probably like 10,000 demand. Everybody's gonna get their chance. Whether you play ball, whether you play football, whether you box, whether you wrestle, whether you fucking swim, whether you want to be the next fucking Michael Phelps, you want to be the next track star, you want to be the next fucking guy that races cars and shit. If you want to design the best car, design the next fucking phone, design the next big laptop, the next shoe, the next sock, the next pants, the next fucking hat, everybody's going to get their turn, literally. And I want everybody to acquire this knowledge and acquire this hope. Everybody will get their turn. What you speak to the world and craving and ambition and wanting anything is the way to speak to the world. If you want something so bad and you speak it into power, you wish it into power, it's gonna happen. I'm firsthand, and I firsthand will tell you that. And I put my life on it. If you want something so bad, it will happen.
The messages X tried to display were the fact everyone is alone.
Whether people think they're alone, whether you're in a relationship, whether you're amongst 1,000 people, you are still alone. Mm-hmm. Because your lies are not known by these other people. Your sins are not known by these other people. Until you confess your sins amongst another man or upon your God or even the devil or even what you believe in, nobody will completely know you. So no one will ever know if you're being honest. No one will ever know what you want them to know. No one will ever know what you want them to know, how you feel, you know?
Right. So you feel alone because you don't have anybody who truly understands everything that you've been through?
To some degree.
Yeah.
It's some things are unexplainable, you know? Some things I can't sit here and talk about because people would think I'm weird or people would think that I'm crazy, you feel me?
They might already think you're crazy.
Yeah, partially.
X's prime message and motto was, what is real will prosper.
Will prosper.
Mm-hmm.
What you feel in the night, what you feel in the morning, what you feel midday that you don't think, other people have the same thoughts. You feel alone in this thought, but other people have the same thoughts, and it breeds. And when you display this thought, it breeds a certain amount of comfort mm-hmm. within people.
Right.
And people start to feel like, all right, this person understands me. This person is fucking cool. So when I say some shit like, oh, hey, I want to fucking gut myself.
All right. So the next section of this documentary is about the alleged abuse case held on XXXTentacion. Now, I need to throw out a few disclaimers because I know this is a heavily sensitive and touchy subject, of course. First of all, I just want to say in this section of the documentary, we don't really express any opinions about the situation, as many people will have conflicting opinions, and we think that it's best to leave you as the viewer to make up your own mind on the whole situation. A very important point to make is the fact that every single thing we state in this section is all alleged. None of this was proven. X was not proven guilty in any way. So that is very important to keep in mind. And lastly, this section is pretty sensitive and will include stories and maybe even images that a lot of people may find offensive. And may not want to see or hear. So on the screen now is the time which you need to skip to if you want to avoid this section. However, I do recommend watching it if you can, because this is a very, very crucial part in the whole life of X. On August the 9th, 2016, X loses his case and is finally arrested for his robbery and assault charges. He was held at Broward Regional Detention Center in Fort Lauderdale. However, he later agrees to house arrest, and this is where his greatest controversy arises.
XXXTentacion. Let's talk about him for a little bit, because now they have obtained, according to Pitchfork, they have a 142-page transcript of testimony by the reported victim of XXXTentacion. And that woman, he has been charged with aggravated battery of a pregnant woman, domestic battery by strangulation, false imprisonment, and witness tampering. He could, if he gets convicted on all four counts, spend a substantial amount of time in prison. His trial is going to start next month, starting October 5th.
The testimony comes from his alleged victim, who shared grim details accusing X of frequent and extensive abuse during the course of their relationship. Pitchfork obtained excerpts from the transcribed 142-page deposition that gives a chronological summary of what she described.
According to his ex-girlfriend, Geneva Ayala, X threatened to
choose between a barbecue pitchfork and a barbecue cleaner, and he was going to put one of them in her vagina. And he would threaten to kill her, and she said when we lived in Orlando, it was literally every single day. Now, she also says while they were in Orlando, she sang along with a verse to somebody else on one of his songs, and that's when he left her in the car outside the venue. They got into a fight, and then he took her in the bathroom and asked her, why was I singing his friend's part of the song? If I like him, why do I like him? Like, do I ever look at his Twitter? And then he headbutted her, punched her, stomped on her, put her in the bathtub, and started hitting and kicking her, and then threatened to, I guess, basically kill her on numerous occasions.
This dude's music must be fire, because I've seen people get put out to paint for less than all that's in that.
Now, this is all just a trans. We don't know what actually happened yet.
That people care about facts nowadays.
He hasn't gone on trial. That starts October 5th.
However, the only evidence other than her own word is this image of her with black eyes. And honestly, no one knows the truth. And of course now, no one ever will. In September of 2016, X agreed to house arrest, but soon after is again accused of assaulting his ex-girlfriend after she confessed to cheating on him. In early October 2016, X was told that Geneva was pregnant with his child. Again, according to her testimony, he threatened to kill her and the unborn child before elbowing her. X allegedly refused to let her go to hospital until her face had healed. On October the 8th, 2016, X was arrested after Geneva had escaped his presence. He was charged with aggravated battery of a pregnant woman, domestic battery by strangulation, false imprisonment, and witness tampering. He pleaded not guilty, but his trial was pushed back several times. And at this point, X was left in jail. During the process of the trial, Geneva actually dropped the charges. However, the court made her put them back on, as they believed this wasn't her true intentions. Of course, we will never know this, but of course, it's also important to know that this case was never solved after multiple investigations into the act, and a lot of people believed that X is completely innocent. Once again, you can make up your own mind on this situation. So X hasn't said a lot about this situation, and initially we weren't planning on putting any defense or any clips of X speaking about the situation, because again, we want you to make up your mind completely. However, I did find a good section in an interview where he does talk about Geneva, and I think it's important to show you. This is just after he came out of jail, and I don't know if it's just me, but you can see the hurt in this guy's face and in this guy's voice. And of course, like, just use this clip to aid making up your own mind.
I have a lot of compassion for the things that I do in my life, but as far as just like everything that goes on around me, I feel like I've become very pessimistic.
Like what? Like what have you seen? Like take us into your life, your journey.
My current situation, just like I spent 9 months in jail by myself for some time, like away from the people I love, I was stuck because I fell in love with the wrong person. And it was a fucked up situation. I fell in love with the wrong person. I tried to give them the world, and I don't want to blame it on the career. It may just be that I'm stupid as a person. It may just be to my negligence or karma catching up to me, but just due to the fact that I must not have been enough. A lot of shit took place.
The second X is out of jail, he's involved in more controversy, but this time it's over beef with heavily mainstream rapper Drake. While X was in prison, Drake was accused of stealing X's flow on Look At Me. The song was previewed as KMT featuring UK rapper Gig. We'll play a clip now and you can see the resemblance.
Okay, okay, okay. Demon just got out of can. I gave my bro an advance.
Hey, all I bitch was your mess. Hey, can't keep my dick in my pants. Hey, my bitch don't love me no more. Hey, she kicked me out on life, bro. Hey.
Son, where'd you find this?
Okay, okay, okay. Demon just got out of can. I gave my bro an advance. Love is just not in my plan.
Can't keep my dick in my pants. All I bitch do is your mess. Ay. Can't keep my dick in my pants. Ay. My bitch don't love me no more. Ay. She kicked me out on life, bro.
Studio right in my yacht.
Why that shit straight to the booth?
How long I been on the street?
She said one fuck bitch.
In February, in an interview with DJ Semtex, Drake denied copying the flow of X's song, which had recently entered the Billboard Top 100 at 95. I was seeing all these comments on my IG saying, what the fuck, you took this kid's flow, and I'm like,
what's happening to me right now?
3 days after his release from jail, in an interview with Miami's 103.5 The Beat, X publicly accused Drake of stealing his flow and thanking his fans for finding the song that Drake released.
Okay. I was talking to her at the time, and she was like, yo, listen to, no, actually, fuck that. It was my dog, Chris. I was on the phone with my dog, Chris. He was like, yo, you gotta listen to this shit. This nigga Drake a fuck nigga. That's exactly what he said. He's like, this nigga Drake a fuck nigga. You gotta listen to this shit. So he plays this shit. I hear da 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 my da. I'm like, what the fuck? As soon as it started, like, I knew he was getting that.
He is not a man.
I think he's a bitch. That's a bitch move.
This beef didn't really progress much further than the two of them talking about each other online.
I'm losing my voice. So, how many of you know I don't want to do this anymore? When I turn it on, I need you to sing that shit, alright? Hey, download I Don't Want to Do This Anymore and play it. I'm gonna do a couple more songs. I love you guys, bro. I love you, bro. I love all of you. I love all of you. Now listen, listen. I got one thing to say, alright? No, no. Not even that, bro. This is about you. Listen, each one of you motherfuckers is special. You see where the fuck I'm at? You can be here. All you gotta do is believe in yourself, bro. You are important, bro. You are important. You are. Each of you motherfuckers is a star. Believe in yourself. Fuck what anybody else says. You hear me? Do you fucking hear me? Play that shit, sing that shit.
In May, X's first ever mixtape, called Revenge, was dropped. This featured 7 songs, including the ever-famous Rip Roach, which is an absolute banger, isn't it, Joe?
You shit! Gang!
However, despite being a hit with his fans, Revenge still didn't break out from his actual fan base and didn't become mainstream or popular in any way. On August the 25th, X's music career took a drastic turn thanks to the arrival of his debut album, 17. This album touched so many people's hearts thanks to his deep lyrics, slow meaningful songs, and contrast between gentle rapping and singing. The whole album was a work of art in my opinion, and many others too.
Just don't seem to compel waiting my death in the end.
Despite the controversy surrounding him, this album gained him so much more respect because he opened up about his deep and inner feelings and thoughts. The music on this album will really live forever, and the way it touched so many people's heart is portrayed by some of the incredible figures the songs made, especially Jocelyn Flores, which was the title song from that album, which has got over, what is it, Joe? 450 million? As of today, says Joe. It's 454, and I got it right, boys.
With Munson being in and out of jail, house arrest and trials for his previous charges, on the 26th of March 2018, X released his second studio album called Question Mark. This album features some of his old high energy music and the new popular style from the album 17. And this album got to top of the Billboard charts just over a week later. This was a massive success for X and SoundCloud Rap.
Just after Question Mark was released, X was straight back to making more music and planned to release 3 albums in 2018.
During X's time, he often tried to display positive messages and always connected with his fanbase. No matter what people say or thought about him, he was always a generous, caring and thoughtful individual that strived to spread nothing but positivity. X was a massive YouTube fan and he supported loads of small YouTubers and actually on occasion met up with them to make videos, get merchandise that he would wear and just in general spread positivity.
Are you YouTuber?
Huh? Yeah. Oh, good. I do have a secret channel, alright?
Yeah.
So what size are you?
Medium.
You're medium?
Alright, this one fits you.
This is my secret channel. My shirt, medium, here's for you. And then my boy has a brand. I was giving away this shirt, but I was like, whatever, I might as well give it to you, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, give him this one, right. Hold the camera.
Appreciate you.
And this is my boy's brand right here. He actually has a brand. It's called Writer.
Oh, that shit hard. I like that. Yo, this one hard.
Hey, that boy likes your shirt.
Hey, nigga, that's all you. That's all you. That's all for you, dog.
I appreciate you. I like that motherfucking W on the back. Yeah. I might promote this shit for you,
bro. Bro, that's all you, bro. I appreciate you, dog.
I'm gonna fuck with you.
Alright, man. Hey.
Yo, I appreciate the motherfucking effort, though, bro. Real shit.
Man, thanks, bro.
You take your shit serious,
no,
bro.
No, I do. I have...
This type of shit is gonna take you far. Keep following.
Thanks, bro.
You,
I appreciate
bro.
It.
It goes very far, and then just even more. Don't get caught up in everything that's outside of your mind. The more time you spend on your mind, I really want you. I really honestly want you to keep on working, because if you don't, it doesn't go anywhere. Everything besides what you got planned does not matter. You gotta stay in your mind.
Exactly. Keep going, dog. Hey, man, I appreciate so much, dog.
That's me and you. Study your laws of the universe. Laws of the universe. Or get the master key.
I appreciate it, dog.
All right, brother.
Have a good one.
On the 22nd of January 2018, X created a video called the Helping Hand Challenge, where he bought loads of PS4s, TVs, clothes, and many more items. He delivered them all to SOS Children's Villages in Florida, which is a charity to provide a family-orientated community, offering healing, hope, and home for children who've got an unfortunate start in life. He asked every single child what they would want to do when they are older, and talks about their dreams. He also gives away every single thing he bought and sings anything the kids wanted him to. He later created his very own Helping Hand Foundation to support the kids from his area.
Okay guys, so I'm going to be starting a challenge. It's called the Helping Hand Challenge. And in this challenge, the way to participate in this challenge is basically whoever makes the most donations gets to meet me, spend a day with me, gets to go out to dinner with me, giggle with me, play video games, and get like a shout out and just simple, something simple, and maybe even $1,000 reward. I'm considering it. I was told I shouldn't do $1,000 reward, but I'll be considering it. But long story short, I'll fly you out, spend the day with you. You know what I'm saying? Be a part of the vlog. It'll be a cool reward. But basically, to participate, the one that wins is the one who documents and helps the most, not only homeless, but the most people in need. It can be any form of person in need, even if it's like going to a shelter or just even feeding the homeless. Whoever does the most good, whoever I see does the most, documents it all, sends it to me, and then I'm able to see it, will win the challenge. It's called the Helping Hand Challenge. Hashtag the Helping Hand Challenge. That is what this video is going to be called, the Helping Hand.
And on October the 20th, 2017, X donated $100,000 to an anti-domestic abuse charity in an attempt to prove he is completely against the act. And also, a month after that, he also hosted an anti-rape event at 2017's Art Basel in Miami.
All right, let's say worst thing comes to worst. I fucking die a tragic death or some shit and I'm not able to see out my dreams. I at least want to know that the kids perceived my message and were able to make something of themselves and able to take my message and use it and turn it into something positive. And to at least have a good life. I at least, if I'm gonna die or ever be a sacrifice, I wanna make sure that my life made at least 5 million kids happy. Or they found some sort of answers or resolve in my life. Regardless of the negative around my name, regardless of the bad things people say to me, I don't give a fuck. Because I know my goal in the end and I know what I want for everyone and I know what my message is. So I just wanted to say, I appreciate and love all of you, and I believe in you all. Do not let your depression make you. Do not let your body define your soul. Let your soul define your body. Your mind is limitless. You are worth more than you could believe. All you have to do is dream, and all you have to do is want to fulfill that dream and have the strength to fulfill that dream. Pain is a sign of progress. When you feel pain, there is progress. I love you all. Make sure you have a good day. And I really wanted to ask, because I found that even when I was in jail and just when I'm home, I think about, and I hate to be cliche or to bring her name up, but I think about the girl that passed away, the girl that killed herself, that I wrote a song about. Hold on, sorry, I'm making a turn. I find myself thinking about her a lot, and I find myself kind of being pessimistic, so I just want to know what's the best way to deal with it, because I feel so much, and it's like, to a degree, it's like I want to feel that pain. I want to always feel attached to her because I was the last person she saw, but at the same time, like, I want resolve for myself, so I want to send me answers, please. That's all I wanted to say. I love you guys. Have a good one.
So I'm not even going to try to bring the energy up or anything like that. Today is June 18th, 2018. We originally had these guys. You guys probably know who they are. Adam22, Lil Xan, and obviously my co-host Keemstar. We originally were gonna have them on, you know, to talk about them, any other ordinary mom's basement. But unfortunately, in light of what's happened today, if you guys haven't heard, I don't know, XXXTentacion passed away today, and it's just kind of really all anybody's talking about right now, and I don't know. They decided to come back on, and we're just gonna kind of just go with the flow and kind of talk about this.
So the 18th of June, 2018 comes around, and the shocking news has broken to the world, stunning everyone in the music industry and millions of fans around the world. It was reported that at approximately 4 p.m. outside Riva Motorsports, XXXTentacion was shot in a drive-by shooting in an attempt of being robbed. Witnesses said he had no pulse at the scene and was not pronounced dead until about 2 hours after in an official police statement on Twitter. 22-year-old.
So we have later decided to not spread any light or give the people that did this horrendous act any time. All I will tell you is that it is believed that every single person involved in this incident is locked up and are in jail for a considerable amount of time. These people will probably not see their normal lives ever again.
X had been planning a charity event on the weekend after his tragic death, but fellow rapper and close friend Ski Master Slump God stated he would like to take over the event in tribute to his brother. The charity event was very successful, and other rappers such as Lil Yachty also attended the event.
A South Florida charity group honoring the final wishes of slain rapper XXXTentacion before he was killed, he was planning a food giveaway in Liberty City. So today, despite his absence, the event went on as planned. The charity group handed out bagged lunches to everyone at that event.
A few days after his death, his management spoke out and asked if fans could donate to his charity for Helping Hand to support the kids that X can sadly no longer provide for. It was also rumoured that Geneva Ayala, his girlfriend which he allegedly abused, was planning to completely drop all of the charges on X. Since his death, his music sales have exploded at a huge 1,600%. And he also broke the all-time streaming world record in one day with his song Sad, which actually got 10.4 million worldwide streams. This absolutely smashed Taylor Swift's record, which was held previously.
That is all we have to say on the legacy of XXXTentacion.
However, he will forever live on through his music. Long live X, what is real will prosper.
Good day. My name is Dwayne Ricardo Onfroy. My son is Jesse Dwayne Ricardo Onfroy. Born January 23rd, 1998. Left this earth physically June 18, 2018, at 20 years old. I will mourn my child from Monday to Monday, 7 days. And after 7 days, I will forever celebrate my child's life. All he accomplished, everything and everyone that he touched. I thank you all for your prayers and your well wishes. If you will join me in mourning him for the first 7 days.
I just don't know what to say. I guess I'm just making this because the information, what I just heard, is that he's passed.
Falling me down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too light for me.
Black people want equality. Everybody wants equality. And then they try and make this black power make equality a whole different privilege. You cannot.
I'm a punk! I'm a punk! You want to play a game? Oh, okay. Alright,
nigga. Oh, it's a beat.
Back up!
That's my cue. No, don't hit that nigga.
Chillin'.
Alright, let's go. What's going on? What's
up, man? Nice to meet you, dog.
Nice to meet you.
He's from Lauder Hill.
Yeah, boy.
Alright, yo, I got a few things for you.
Yeah,
you a YouTuber? Yeah.
Oh, good.
I have a sneaker channel, alright?
Yeah.
So, what's that,
That's all I got right now.
Long live X,
our young dagger dick.
Young, you want me to call you young dagger dick?
I believe in the human race, period, and I truly believe that anyone can be what they want to be. We need people to ideally take care of the world. We need good mothers. We need good fathers. We need
great guy.
Hey, glad that we could.
Oh, other hand.
That's left-handed.
Yeah, that's the fault, nigga.
Hey, you got a good handshake too, man.
He's a great guy, bro. He's gonna make you feel comfortable.